Hello everyone, welcome to PCBE classes. In this lecture, we will be discussing about the short circuit and the open circuit. Fine, so let's start the lecture. Now, before starting the concept of the short circuit and the open circuit, you should be aware of the what do you mean by the short circuit and what do you mean by the open circuit. Basically, this short circuit and the open circuit is stated as the short circuit is a path where opposition is very very less, that is tends to zero. That means the opposition is very less. In case of the open circuit, it is the same. It is a path where this opposition is very very high. Opposition is very very high. That is tends to infinite. Clear? So, it is short circuit and the open circuit is basically said in this way, that is short circuit is a path where the opposition is very very less in case of the short circuit, whereas opposition is very very high, that is tending to infinite in case of the open circuit. Now, how to understand what is this opposition is? Let's take an example. The example what we will be taking that can be understood by any of the layman, fine. So let's see that one. Suppose, for example, a path is there. You can take a road, fine, and you are walking over this road. You are walking very freely over this road. What happens? Suddenly, some landslides occurs, or due to some constructional work over the road has been detached. It has been divided. Right, and there is a gap produced, that is a AB gap is produced, and the gap is of 0.1 meter. Now you want to travel from this side to the right side. You can consider like from left hand to the right side. That means you have to cross from A to B. What is the distance here? 0.1 meter, it can be overcome. 0.1 meter, if it is a gap is there, can you travel that side? Yes, we can travel it. What you will do? You will take a jump. Fine, you will jump it and you will come this side. Fine. Similarly, suppose I am taking the same condition, but the gap is increased as 0.5 meter. You want to travel from here to this side. Clear? 0.5 meter difference is there. Can you pass that side? Yes, we can pass. How? We can again jump this side. Because for a normal human being, 0.1 meter gap, it can jump, as well as 0.5 meter also gap, it can be jumped. Right? Suppose what happens, that difference becomes more and it becomes around 7 meter to 10 meter gap is there. Can you travel from A to B? Can you jump? No. So, jumping cannot be done. Can you pass that side from left hand side to the right hand side? No. Fine. So, what I mean to say is that in the first case, the opposition or the hurdle what you faced while walking is a small gap, right? 0.1 meter. Don't take it as an open circuit, right? I am saying that 0.1 meter opposition is very very less to you. So I'll say that opposition is very very less, or I can say it is less. Fine. Next, what happens? Opposition is more. Opposition is more. Even though it is more, you have ample amount of energy that you can travel from this side to that side. You can jump it. But what happens if the gap is 7 meter to 10 meter, then it's beyond your capability to jump from A to B and to move that side. So can you pass this side? No. Can you jump? No. You cannot travel. That means the opposition is very, very high. Very, very high, due to which you cannot travel that side. In electrical way, I'll explain you. Consider this person is a current and this is a conductor. The opposition, don't take it as an open circuit. Again, I'm saying it. Consider it's an opposition. Opposition means what in electrical? Resistance, right? So the resistance offered in the walking, for the walking of the person, is very less. I can say the resistance is less. Fine. Then it covers that resistance and it overcomes that resistance and it comes from the left hand side to the right hand side. Fine. Similarly, the resistance becomes more. The resistance is increased. Then also it is in his limit. That is why the person can jump from the left hand side to the right hand side. But what happens here? Resistance is very very high. Then what happens here? It is beyond the capability of the current to pass from A terminal to the B terminal, right? And it's approaching high means what? It's approaching to infinite. So this type of condition is said to the open circuit condition. Electrically, I am explaining it again. This is a circuit where current flows, but can the current pass this side? No, because this terminal is open. Open means what? The resistance tends to infinite. If it is tends to infinite, can the current pass that side? Because it is said that the opposition to the flow of current is so much high that the current cannot pass from left side to the right side. So this is the open circuit condition. Fine. So this condition is said to the open circuit condition. So I can say that in case of open circuit, what we'll say, opposition is resistance, where resistance tends to infinite. We'll see for the short circuit case. We'll come in the reverse way of the open circuit. Suppose it is 0.5 meter, or let us take it is 1 meter. Distance is there. Can you travel? Yes, you can jump it. So what you will do? You will jump this side and the person can come from the left to the right. Now what I'll, because for jumping also, for this jump, you are losing certain energy. Suppose it is 2 meter, right? You can jump, but for jumping, a certain amount of energy you have to lose. If you are losing certain of energy, then you can travel from the left side to the right hand side. Suppose the construction workers have done some arrangement and this part they have done a full fledged. What is here? Opposition. Opposition is present. Opposition is present. That means resistance is present. Resistance is present. But what happens if it is the construction workers came and they have done some maintenance work and they have made the road perfect? Then will you lose any energy to come from the left hand side to the right hand side? No. That means what? It's maintained properly. That means you will be losing anything. No energy will be lost, as well as no opposition is offered, that means you will travel very smoothly from here to here, from left to the right. This condition is said to the short circuit because the resistance is very low, that is tending to zero. Opposition is zero. If there is no opposition, then the current can be traveled from one point to the another. Similarly, you can travel here as a road maintained properly, so you can smoothly travel from the left to the right side without any opposition. Fine. This type of condition is said to the short circuit condition. Let's see in the circuit. If it is a short circuit, what is the resistance here? Zero. Resistance is zero. Then current will be, can the current flow? Yes. Current will be flowing. What will be the voltage? IR, I into R, that is zero. So voltage will be zero. This is a condition for the short circuit in case of the electrical circuit. This is a short circuit condition. Now let's see what it happens ideally and the practically. I'm taking an ideal case. This is an ideal case I'm taking it. Clear? So I'm taking a voltage source. Let us take 5 volt is present. For example, now which case I am considering? Short circuit. So what I'll do, these two terminals I am joining it. If I am joining it, what is the resistance across it? This is short circuit condition. This is short circuit condition. What is the resistance across it? Zero ohms. As these two terminals are there, so I am taking this one as positive and this one as negative, that is V. Now for the short circuit case, what will be the voltage here? As R equals to zero, so whatever may be the current entering here, we don't know what is the current entering here, whatever may be the current entering here, V equals to IR. Fine. V equals to IR means what will be the V? I into zero. So it is 0 volt. So what is the condition we are getting here? R equals to 0, V equals to 0. Now let us find out what is the current flowing here. Current. Which current? This one? I. What is the resistance here? 0. So current will be equals to V by R. What is this one? V by R means this current is flowing from the 5 volt. So I am taking this one as 5 by 0. Let us take this current as IS. Now I am finding out this IS, which is equals to I, V by R. So 5 by 0, it is infinite. So what is the current? Infinite. Now tell me one thing, can a finite voltage source can supply an infinite current? It's not possible. It is never ever possible. That is one thing to be noted. So what is the note you will be writing down? Second thing, if I'll apply KVL here, what will happen? If I'll apply KVL, let us write down the KVL equation. What is that? Minus 5, this is positive, this is negative. Minus 5 plus V equals to 0. What is the V here? Minus 5 plus 0 equals to 0. Is it minus 5 equals to 0? Or 5 equals to 0? Never. That means what? KVL violates. So this ideal case, practically it is not feasible, right? So what is the ideal conditions we are getting here? Across the short circuit, resistance
is 0, voltage is 0, current equals to infinite, which is not feasible. Let us go to the practical case. What is the practical it is saying? A voltage source I am taking. Fine. I need to consider a short circuit case. So I am taking these two terminals, I am connecting it. That means what? This is a short circuit. Resistance equals to 0. The resistance equals to 0. Now this source will pump some current, and after reaching this point, the current observes that in order to come back to the 5 volt, it has two paths. In one, the opposition is there, another, the opposition is not there. So which path will be choosing? Naturally, you justify in this way. You are riding a bike and you have to travel from your home to a particular place. In order to reach that particular place, you have two different paths. One path, lot of hurdles are there or lot of speed breakers are there, right? Another is a highway. So which one you will be choosing? Because if you move in the hurdle way, then you will be facing lot of opposition, your speed will be decreased, fine. But if you follow a highway, there is no speed breakers and you can reach very quick and you will not lose any energy. So which path you will be choosing? Naturally, the highway you will be choosing. Similarly, the current, when it comes to this node, this point, it has two paths. In one path, the opposition is there, another path, the opposition is zero. So which path it will choose? This path it will choose. Will any current flow in this 2 ohm? No current will flow. Then what will be my circuit? My circuit will be in this way. As no current flows through the 2 ohm, I am not considering it. Rather, the short circuit path I am considering it. What is this one? Current. What will be my current? What is the resistance here? 0. Fine. What is the voltage across it? This V. V will be equals to 0 because resistance is 0. What will be my current? What is the current flowing through it? Current flowing through will be the 5 divided by 1, that will be equals to 5 ampere. Is it not the 5 ampere is a finite value? Yes, it's a finite value. So what I'll write down for the practical case: resistance is 0, voltage is 0, current is finite. Generally, in ideal case, what happens? Current tends to infinite, where in the practical case, the current will be finite. You can make a note of it. This you can take a basic example. 5 volt is a finite voltage. Now I am considering the open circuit case. Fine. For the ideal case, I am taking it. I am taking for an ideal case. Let us take a current source is there. I am taking a current source, finite current source. Fine. So I am taking this one as a 5 ampere. Or let us take 10 ampere. Clear? Finite source is there. And I am stating that it's a open circuit condition. If it is an open circuit condition, what is the resistance offered here? Already we know about it. R will be equals to infinite. So what is the first condition? R equals to infinite. Now what will be the current flowing in the open circuit? Let us take R open circuit and current open circuit. What will be the current? As it is open, 10 ampere is flowing, but here what is the current here?
0.
Can this 10 ampere flow from this terminal to this terminal?
No,
because the resistance is too high that it doesn't allow the current. So the current becomes 0 here. If this is the case, if I'll take the voltage across it, let us take V naught. So what will be the V naught? V naught will be equals to infinite. V naught will be equals to whatever may be the current, we don't know about it, but multiply with the resistance, it will be infinite. So what is the ideal conditions we are getting? R equals to infinite, current equals to 0, and voltage across the open circuit is equals to infinite. These are the three conditions what we are getting it. Fine. Now see here, what is the main note we have to do? Note. Can a finite current source produce an infinite voltage across an open circuit? That is the first point. A finite, that is the first thing. Fine. Now see here, what is the current here? 10 ampere. What is the current here? 0. Suddenly the current changes from 10 ampere to the 0. Is it possible? 10 ampere, charge can neither be created nor be destroyed as we have discussed it. So it violates the law of conservation of charge, or it violates the KCL. 10 ampere is entering, but the current is 0. Is it entering current is equals to the, what we have learned, entering current should be equals to the delivery current. 10 ampere is entering, that is equals to 0 ampere. Is it so? No. That means second point is KCL, whereas for the short circuit case it violates the law of conservation of energy. Fine. So this type of case is not possible. So what is a practical case? Let us see that one. And I am taking, considering an open circuit condition. Open circuit condition. Let us take the resistance value is 1 ohm. Resistance value is 1 ohm. This is a 10 ampere current flows. Now, will it pass this side? Can the current pass this side? No. So, current is 0. As it is open circuit condition, what is the resistance here? Infinite. Resistance equals to infinite. Then what will be the voltage here? We'll see now. The 10 ampere, can it pass this side? No. So the 10 ampere will be passing through the 1 ohm. That this is the 10 ampere will be passing through the 1 ohm. So what is the voltage drop across this one? 10 into 1. So what will be the voltage drop across 1 ohm? 10 into 1, that will be 10 volt. Is it parallelly connected? Yes. So what will be the voltage V here? If I'll take this one as positive and this one as negative, what will be the V here? This V will be equals to V 1 ohm, that is equals to 10 volt, which is finite in nature. So practically, what are the conditions? What are the conditions for the practical case? Resistance equals to infinite, no doubt. Current equals to 0. Voltage is finite. Clear? Practically, for open circuit case, we'll draw in this way. This is an open circuit case, this is a short circuit case. Short circuit case. In case of open circuit, the current becomes 0. Why? Because the resistance is infinite. But can we say the voltage is infinite? No. What we'll say? Voltage is finite.
Clear? Current cannot pass. In case of short circuit, can the current pass? Yes. What is the resistance here? Resistance equals to 0. What will be the voltage? 0. What will be the current? Will I say it is infinite? No. It will be finite in nature. Whatever the source current will be flowing, or the main source current will be flowing, that will be the same current we have seen in the example. Fine? This you have to make a note. This is about today's lecture about the open circuit and the short circuit case. Implementation over the problems we'll be seeing in the problem session. Clear? Thank you.